Natalie Diaz, welcome by the banks of the Colorado River.
Thanks. Welcome to our home.
Did you grow up with a sense of identity as a Mojave, with a sense of the culture?
My father's also Spanish, so we grew up with his grandparents, or with my grandparents, his parents. So we had a lot of different cultures in my household. So I was exposed to Spanish, exposed to our Mojave culture, and I'm also Pima. From the outside the Phoenix area. So mm-hmm. We had a little bit of everything in our house.
For you, basketball was your passion, right? And in a sense, even, is it escape too strong a word? What was it for you?
I think escape would be a good word, and passion and a lot of other things. It was one way I was able to kind of quiet my life a little bit. The basketball is really big on most reservations, but ours especially. And I think it was kind of my way to navigate between the different cultures on the reservation. If you're good at basketball, you could do anything. You fit into any group.
Now we're talking about poetry. Now, where does that fit into among the passions or drive?
When I think of writing, to me, I think of a sense of hunger in me. Writing doesn't ever fully satisfy me, and that's why I do it. When you feel like you've completed something or you really know something, it almost seems like you don't really need to do that anymore. But for me, writing it's kind of a way for me to explore why I want things and why I'm afraid of things and why I worry about things. And for me, all of those things represent a kind of hunger that comes with, being raised in a place like this.
And many of the poems, of course, in this volume do look at life here.
A lot of the images that I've grown up with, that's kind of how I filter the world, through those images. And those images carry meaning for me. A lot of the words I use, that's the way we talk here. That's the way I've learned to express myself, or at least to try to express myself.
Well, there's good things and there's bad things, right? There's humor, and then there's one running theme about a brother who has a serious drug problem.
In this community, addiction is it's almost become something normalized, in an area like this. But what I deal with my brother is kind of how he's affected our family, and how that's changed or altered or wrecked our family structure. And I think we, just in general, in the community I come from, Mojaves are very humorous people. And they've managed to find a balance between humor, even in the face of some of the tragedies and some of the, the darkness that we live with. And it's just a way, I think, of surviving. And so I can't fix some of the things in my life. I can't change my brother, at this point. But at least I'm able to kind of wrestle with that with words.
Let me ask you about the work you're doing now to preserve the language. I wonder, what is the goal? I mean, it's not a fluency. I don't think you're expecting everyone to speak Mojave to each other in their daily lives, or are you? Or is it more about identity generally?
Well, I think there's a lot of layers for it. I think the goal in any revitalization program always has to be that we will again speak Mojave at Fort Mojave, that our kids will learn Mojave in their homes, that the babies will hear that as a first language. And that always has to be the goal. However, in between that, because we know that's a very lofty goal, mm-hmm. and our elders will tell you that, and they're constantly reminding us of the time crunch. we have this many years, and we're supposed to do this, 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 and this. How are we going to get there? But
it is a race against time, in a sense.
It definitely is. But in the meantime, we have to hit all of those smaller goals, which, like for us, working with the high school students, letting them know that being Mojave it's something they carry with them. Because for us, the most important thing is that when our kids leave, that one, they feel like they can come back, but also that when they leave, they're carrying part of themselves as Mojave, to carrying those values with them, and then representing the tribe also when they leave.
Okay, Natalie Diaz, nice to talk to you.
Thanks, Jeff.